this morning. Let's talk about this settlement. Frontier Communications is going to pay $160 million in this settlement for what the Attorney General Patrick Marcy says is slower than promised internet speeds. Now, $150 million of that is for additional work that Frontier is going to do. $10 million will go to customers to settle the complaints about the internet speed. Again, a couple of there are different takes on this settlement. We'll talk to Frontier in a moment. But earlier today, I talked with West Virginia Attorney General Patrick Marcy and asked him about what he said this settlement means that Frontier was or was not doing.
Well, Hoppy, I think many people believe that the Frontier service was slow or did not meet the expectations when they purchased a high-speed internet product. And what this agreement is doing is it's actually going to be investing in to fix the infrastructure. This is very significant for the state because if we can start to get the baseline speeds way up and ultimately connect many more people in West Virginia, that's good for consumers. That's obviously good for the economy as a whole.
Mm-hmm. I'll get more into that in a moment. It's significant, isn't it, though, that Frontier, in entering this agreement, does not concede it did anything wrong, right?
Well, I think sometimes when you're involved in a dispute, this obviously is as a result of an investigation that we've been working on over the last 18 months. And anytime you have a dispute between the state and a company, in order to avoid litigation, you come to an agreement. And obviously both parties give something away in the process. What we've done here, we think, is going to represent a big step forward for consumers. Frontier did work with us in good faith to construct the agreement, so we're pleased with that. But we made a choice that rather than have lengthy litigation that could last 3, 4, 5 years, that it was better to make the investment in the internet infrastructure now. This has never been done out of the Attorney General's office before, and I thought it was critical to take a major step forward so we could start to move forward economically and have a real impact on consumers today. Because, Hoppy, as you know, there's a lot of uncertainty in the courts, and while we feel very good with the issues that we brought to the table, when you can get a $160 million settlement, the single largest independently negotiated settlement in our state's history, you take it and then you move forward, and this will be the first step of a number that you'll likely see our office involved in.
Patrick Morris is with us, West Virginia Attorney General. You point out largest independently negotiated because it was done entirely through your office. The largest would have been the tobacco settlement where outside counsel was used. I think I'm correct about that. But
that is correct.
Okay. So how many customers will get a reduction in their bills, by how much, and how is that determined?
Well, a couple things. First, there's one category of customers, which would be 28,000 individuals who are provisioned at about the 1.5 meg level or lower. They're going to see a reduction in their bills, likely beginning the end of January, from either $29.99 or $19.99 down to $9.99. Then there'll be another class of individuals who may not fall in that 28,000 category, where it's unclear what they may be provisioned at right now, and yet they're having real problems getting high-speed internet. The company has indicated that it's going to work with us in good faith in order to not only fix the infrastructure there, but to treat these customers appropriately. So we believe that the immediate consumer relief will apply first to the 28,000 bucket, but separately, there could be many other consumers that receive that benefit in terms of rate relief. And then beyond that, Hoppy, there will literally be many tens of thousands of individuals who are going to see the benefit from the enhanced infrastructure and the added connectivity, because this is going to go a long way forward to connecting many more homes in the state of West Virginia.
Let's drill down on that a little bit, because of the $160 million, $10 million is, as you just talked about, reduction in monthly bills to certain customers. The $150 million in infrastructure investment, wasn't Frontier planning to do that anyway? Wasn't that on their timetable anyway?
Well, Hoppy, the public announcement that they've had is that they were going to expend $180 million for the Connect America Fund, and this $150 million is on top of that $180 million, and so it's quite significant. And I'm hopeful we're going to see continued numbers even beyond this from Frontier as they remain committed to the state. So these are significant numbers, and obviously none of these numbers had ever been discussed before. So I thought this was a very significant change. And two things, Hoppy. One, it's beyond what's been publicly discussed. And two, the value of this in terms of the investments and the consumer relief will not get passed on to consumers. That was one of the provisions of the agreement, which I thought was important.
Patrick Morrissey is with us, West Virginia Attorney General, on this $160 million settlement with Frontier Communications. And Patrick, I think all this started with the service from Frontier called High Speed Internet Max, which promised a certain high speed internet access. But the allegation was that the company throttled back internet speeds. Was that your finding? Was that your determination? I want to go back to which is back to my original question. In your opinion, did Frontier not deliver what it promised?
Well, we do not believe that the service met the expectations of the customers, and that's why we pursued the investigation, and ultimately that's why we reached the agreement. I want to be clear, in the agreement, there is no admission, and we worked in good faith with the company in order to resolve these issues. But we had a lot of complaints on these points for the last 18 months, probably about 75 written complaints. But then beyond that, in all of the town halls that I've done across the state, probably half of those we received complaints about the nature of the service and the speed for this category of customer. And so that's what really motivated us. But keep in mind, this is a first step. There may be other developments coming soon which continue to make high-speed internet better in the state of West Virginia.
That's Attorney General Patrick Morrissey, my conversation with him earlier today.